Wow, it's so hot every day. Have to go into the office today to make sure we don't die from the heat wave. So let's go.
In Seattle, about 70% of people don't have air conditioning because you typically don't need it. These are exceptionally hot temperatures with heat warnings in effect all across the Northwest. And, you know, normally we talk about triple-digit heat in the Southwest where it's dry, but it's also fairly humid in the Northwest as well. So that's going to add to just how uncomfortable it feels.
Oh, feels so much better in my car with the air conditioning. You know, 70% of Seattle apartments and residents don't have air conditioning. It's like a complete opposite of Singapore, where 100% of all of the buildings have air conditioning. Because as Lee Kuan Yew once said, air conditioning is the most important and most useful invention in the entire world that is absolutely 100% on point. There was an actual alert that's going around for the entire Pacific Northwest. For about 25 million people affected, and it's crazy. It's if you use Fahrenheit, it's going above 100, so it's about 110 next week perhaps. But if you use Celsius scale like everybody else in the entire world does, that it's going to be around 43 to 45 degrees Celsius, which is crazy.
Alexa, temperature now.
Extremely dangerous. That's us. Yep, we're not used to it at all.
In fact, it is a once in a thousand year event. When you see the purple,
wow.
Is a once in a thousand year event.
What does once that mean? In a millennium. That's right crazy.
Here, let's say, for a thousand years, you would only experience a heat dome like this maybe one time.
Well, I've only been here for 2 years.
So this is what's causing all this. We have a big blocking pattern or traffic jam in the atmosphere. You can see this very wavy jet stream. So instead of storm systems moving quickly from west to east, they get stuck in these waves right here. And this right here is called an omega block.
Well, that's
block.
A pretty cool visualization, I would say.
Block, and it's some
it looks very dangerous, though.
Too hot to get anywhere. I really want to jump into a swimming pool or go to a water park or something like that.
And I actually see a lot more people than usual in the mall, walking around, sitting around with their phones, just taking advantage of the air conditioning, you know? Obviously, it's pretty cool. And the greater Seattle area is opening up fully on the June 30th, so pretty nice vibe around here.
So we are going to Home Depot to look for fans, box fans, or air conditioners. I'm not hopeful. I don't think I can find any because of the heat wave. I think everyone's stockpiling box fans, probably more than they ever needed. And I think the current situation for box fans or any sort of air conditioner related products is kind of like toilet paper back in March or April last year, where everyone was just crazy and phonetically snatching up all of the toilet papers. My parents, my dad specifically, always told me that I should get a fan as soon as possible, and I waited, I shouldn't have done that. And now, yep, I can't get a fan for myself. Let's see what we're gonna get today.
Well, I just found something better than fans. Here. You can just stay in there. Well, I was not able to find anything at all. The guy just told me that basically all of the box fans, all of the fans, all of the air conditioners were out.
Since this morning, there were three shipments in the morning, and everybody basically snatched up everything in 10 minutes. All of the 50 fans, along with other like air humidifiers, anything that's related to air at all, it's gone. So that's fine. I have air conditioning in my car, so I'll be able to survive. And I'll go to the office right now.
20 minutes later.
오늘은 지금 진짜 정말 너무 더워요.
I could give you guys a quick
office tour.
But right before that, we gotta hit the store and get some refreshing summer lemon black tea and some takeouts for lunch, of course. And I'll see you in the office.
People have brought their toddlers and their whole family to office because there's free air conditioning, of course. Surprisingly not crowded. I thought there's gonna be so many people in the office taking advantage of the free air conditioning and the free soft drinks, of course, and free coffee. Everything. It's perfect. Nice.
And voila, here's my lunch at this cozy air-conditioned office. So let me show you guys around. This is the lobby with some fancy artwork, and this is the greater Seattle area that's on fire at the moment. And for some reason, someone has a desk in a conference room, so I guess, you know, people do whatever they want in the office nowadays, huh? And here is the pod that our team works in. So, you know, it's an open office concept. You know, some people like it, some people hate it, but this is my desk and I love it, you know. I really miss this setup, you know, I miss my standing desk. I haven't been in the office for about a year and a half now, so it's been a long while, you know. And this is my chair that I'm pretty sure is pretty expensive. I don't know how much it costs, but yeah, pretty nice dual monitor setup. I stole these monitors from my neighbors because I was too lazy to bring my monitors back to the office. Yeah, so this is it. I guess I'm just gonna sit here, enjoy the AC, and let's check the temperature. Holy cow, it's 40 degrees Celsius at the moment. I feel very privileged to be in the office. Just look at the scorching sun outside. So anyways, the heat wave has kind of sort of subsided, and it's cooling down a little bit now. I think today it's been around 28 to 30 degrees Celsius the whole day. For the past 3 days, I've been staying in the office, basically sheltering in office, taking advantage of the free air conditioning. So I'm glad that I survived it. And you can see that exponentially every year, there's more and more and more natural hazards and disasters happening all around us. It's pretty crazy. And actually, this also reminds me of 2019, before I graduated, you know, like my last year of college. We actually witnessed once in a hundred year event of polar vortex that is potentially life-threatening. And our college actually shut down. And our college has never shut down for anything, for cold weather, for tornadoes, for anything. It's never shut down for 60 years or so. You can actually die. I feel like I have actually experienced both extremes of temperature in my life. You know, 2019 polar vortex, negative 40 degrees Celsius, and I survived it on the higher end of the temperature scale. I've been here this past Monday when it was 43, or I think 44 degrees Celsius here, and it was crazy because I didn't have air conditioning, so I don't know how I felt asleep. It feels like I was in one of those spas or steam room, or in Korean, jimjilban, for a whole night, basically steaming myself and sweating and just really hard to fall asleep. It was a very tough few days, but yeah. Thank you so much for watching, random people from the internet who are curious about the heat waves in the Pacific Northwest, and I hope that I have given you a kind of a brief idea of what it felt like to be in hell. Again, thank you so much for watching. That's the end of the video. See you next time. Bye-bye.